teacher Daisy. Today, I'm going to teach you Asas Sains Komputer Chapter 3. I will explain this subject in English and Malay. However, the exam is using Malay, so you need to remember the terms in Malay. Let's start now. In this chapter, you will learn Algoritma, Pseudokod, and Carta alir involving Struktur Kawalan Pilihan and Struktur Kawalan Ulangan. Besides that, you will also learn the ways of finding ralat in Pseudokod and Carta alir. First, let us look at Algoritma. Suppose Alice wants to cross the road to the KFC side, what should she do? First, look left. If no vehicle on left, look right. If no vehicle on right, look left again. If no vehicle on left, then cross the road. Finally, Alice successfully crossed the road. The step-by-step instruction to solve the problem is called algoritma. There are many algoritma happens in our life. For example, making bread, making matcha green tea, and washing your hands. Algoritma is step-by-step instructions to solve the problem. There are four important points when writing algoritma. First, algoritma must be written in a language human can understand. Second, the description or steps must be clear and accurate. Third, the sequence must be correct. Fourth, algorithm must have an output in a period of time. Algorithm can be represented in many ways, especially in Pseudokod and Carta alir. Now, let's have a look at the first way of representing the algorithm, Pseudokod. Pseudokod uses simple, concise sentences to represent the steps of the algorithm. The example of Pseudokod is like this. The white spaces in front of the lines are called indent. Indent are widely used to make Pseudokod easier to read. The second way to represent the algorithm is Carta alir. Carta alir uses simple graphic, for example, garis lurus, anak panah, and bentuk geometry to represent the algorithm. There are six simple graphic for Carta alir you must remember. First, terminal. Terminal is used for mula and tamat. Second, pilihan. Pilihan is used when there is a decision and have two options, either ya or tidak. Third, process. Process is to show activities performed in Carta alir. Fourth, input or output. Input is used to read and save data, while output is to view and print data. Fifth, garis alir. Garis alir is used to connect symbols and show the flow in Carta alir. Sixth, penyambung. Penyambung is used to connect Carta alir with other sections. Let us look at an example. This is an algorithm to check the function of the lamp. First, check whether the plug is plugged into the socket. If not, plug the plug into the socket. Second, check whether a socket switch is installed. If not, install the socket switch. Third, turn on the light switch. Fourth, if the light is on, turn off the light switch and skip to step 7. Fifth, if not on, check if the bulb burns. If the bulb burns out, replace the bulb with a new one. Sixth, if it does not burn, repair the lamp circuit. Seventh, done. This algorithm can be represented in Pseudokod and Carta alir. Now, let me introduce Struktur Kawalan Pilihan. Struktur Kawalan Pilihan is a way of breaking down the flow of an algorithm into two or more branches. In Struktur Kawalan Pilihan, we'll use pengendali hubungan. The pengendali hubungan are as follow. Sama dengan, lebih besar daripada, lebih besar atau sama dengan, lebih kecil atau sama dengan. There are three types of struktur kawalan pilihan. First, pilihan tunggal, single selection. Pilihan tunggal only have one option to execute actions. If one condition tested is true, then a set of actions will be executed. Second, dui pilihan, double selection. Dui pilihan is choosing between two actions or two sets of actions to perform. If the tested condition is true, then action set A will be executed. If false, then action set B will be executed. Third, berbagai pilihan, multi-selection. Berbagai pilihan has more than two statements of action for implementation. The action chosen to be executed depends on the choice of conditions that are found to be true. We will have a look at the examples for these three pilihan. First, if marks lebih besar atau sama dengan 40, output pass. Second, if marks lebih besar atau sama dengan 40, output pass. If marks kecil daripada 40, output fail. Third, if marks lebih besar atau sama dengan 80, output A. If marks lebih besar atau sama dengan 60, output B. If marks lebih besar atau sama dengan 40, output C. And if marks kecil daripada 40, output D. After that, let us learn the Struktur Kawalan Ulangan. In Struktur Kawalan Ulangan, there is a set of actions that will be executed repeatedly. The part of the algorithm that contains repeated steps is known as the gelong. Each gelong is called as the laran. Let me introduce the Struktur Kawalan Ulangan one by one. First, untuk, for. This type of Struktur Kawalan Ulangan is used when you know how many times you want to repeat. At first, set the pembilang to 1. After that, check if the pembilang smaller or equals to the times you want to repeat. Let's say it's n times you want to repeat. If it is less than or equals to n times, then loop again. Second, selagi, while. This type of Struktur Kawalan Ulangan repeat as long as the condition is true. Every time, we'll check the condition before execute the statement. Check if the syarat is true. If true, then loop the statements. If false, then go out from the loop. Third, ulang-sehingga, repeat until. This type of Struktur Kawalan Ulangan repeat as long as the condition is true. Every time, we'll check the condition after execute the statement. The statement will execute at least once. Run the statement, then check if the syarat is true. If false, then loop the statements. If true, then go out from the loop. Let us look at the examples for the Struktur Kawalan Ulangan. First, output merdeka for 3 times. In this example, we use Struktur Kawalan untuk because we know how many times we want to do the gelong already. The way of drawing the carta alir and writing the pseudocode will be look like this. Second, add nombor as many times as you want. This one, we use Struktur Kawalan selagi. Third, run the program as many times as you want, but at least once. So this one, we use Struktur Kawalan Ulang Sehingga. Using Struktur Kawalan Ulangan will help us simplify our carta alir and pseudocode, and no need to write the repeat things again and again. After learning Struktur Kawalan, now we move on to the ralat. Ralat means an error found in algorithm or program. Ralat causes an algorithm or program to not work as expected. and produce unexpected output. Normally, the ralat file in algorithma is ralat logic, which is caused by human error when developing an algorithma. Ralat logic can occur when an incorrect action is asked to be performed or the sequence of execution of the action is incorrect. After develop an algorithm, we need to do checking. There are two techniques for checking, also known as semakan quality. First, technique semakan meja, desk check. Second, technique langkah demi langkah, step through. We will look at the two checking techniques one by one. First, semakan meja. Semakan meja is a technique manual for checking the logic and the flow of the steps of an algorithm. Technique manual means do not need a machine. Therefore, this technique uses only paper and pencil. During the technique semakan meja, the reviewer uses sample data and processes this data manually according to algorithm steps. The output obtained is compared with the expected output. Let's see an example. Check the Carta alir below that determines the largest number of the two numbers m and n inputted. You can choose any number for m and n. Let's say I choose 8 for m and 9 for n. So my expected largest number among these two is 9. Now let's check through this Carta alir. Input number m is 8. Input number n is 9. Is 8 greater than 9? Tidak. So, number terbesar is 9. Then, we will output the result. Now, we can see the output diperoleh and dijangka are the same. It works fine for this sample data. Let us try out with different sample data. Let us input 9 for M and 8 for N now. So the expected largest number among these two is 9. Is 9 greater than 8? Yeah. So nombor terbesar is 9. Now we can see the output diperoleh and dijangka are the same. It works fine for this sample data also. Let us see another sample data to check on our Carta alir. Let us input 8 for M and N. So the expected output should be same value. Is 8 greater than 8? Tidak. So nombor terbesar is 8. So the output diperoleh and dijangka are different. There is a ralat here. That means, through the semakan meja and use sample data, we find out these Carta alir have ralat and need to fix. The Carta alir after fixing will be looks like this. The second technique, technique langkah demi langkah. During this technique, logic of each algorithm sequence is checked. This technique is suitable for algorithm that cannot be checked using sample data. We will also look at an example for this technique. Check out the Carta alir below that displays the sum of all numbers between 1 and 10. Let us check on the flow of this Carta alir. First, jumlah is 0. Number also 0. Is 0 smaller than 10? Yeah. Add nombor to jumlah. 0 plus 0 equals to 0. After that, add 1 to number. Is 1 smaller than 10? Yeah. Add nombor to jumlah. 1 plus 0 equals to 1. After that, add 1 to nombor. So nombor is 2 now. Is 2 smaller than 10? Yeah. Add nombor to jumlah. 2 plus 1 equals to 3. After that, add 1 to nombor. So nombor is 3 now. Continue the rest with the same steps until nombor is 10. Is 10 smaller than 10? Tidak. You can see from just now the steps, actually the jumlah is add up 0 to 9 instead of 1 to 10. So there is a ralat. This method uses technique langkah demi langkah because it do not need sample data, but only go through every sequence will do. After learning Ralat, now we go to the last section in this chapter. Before that, let us understand what is input, process, and output. Input is the materials or data needed. Process is the steps can be taken to produce something. Output is the results after the process carried out. For example, making a cake. Input is ingredients. Process is the step to make a cake. Output is the cake. Another example is log in to Instagram. Input is the name or email and password. Process is checking if the user exists. Output, if user exists, then go to his Insta homepage. And if user not exists, ask to try again. There are some keywords for input and output. When you see input, baca, dapatkan, and masukkan are means input. While when you see output, papar, cetak are means output. The steps to generate an algorithm in the form of pseudocode and carta alir. First, mengenal pasti masalah. Second, menentukan data yang perlu digunakan. Third, menentukan proses atau tugas yang perlu dilaksanakan. Fourth, menentukan output yang diingini. Fifth, mereka bentuk algoritma. Sixth, menulis pseudocode dan melukis carta alir bagi sesuatu algoritma. Example, set up an algoritma that displays the price of petrol from 1 to 100 liters when given the price per liter. First, kenal pasti masalah. The masalah is to display the price of petrol from 1 to 100 liters. Second, data input. The data input is the price per liter. Third, process. The process is to calculate the price of petrol from 1 to 100 liters. Fourth, output. The output is to display the price of petrol from 1 to 100 liters. Fifth, mereka bentuk algoritma. Sixth, menulis pseudocode dan melukis carta alir.
If you find this video is helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And if you got any question, can comment below. Thanks for watching.